You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web, and your number one source for after-show entertainment.
Very good, Dean
Johnson. From the AfterBuzz studios in Los Angeles, California, and streaming live on Ustream, this is AfterBuzz TV for So You Think You Can Dance. Tonight's host is Kat Bayless. Joining Kat will be AfterBuzz co-hosts Ashanti Moselle, Janora McDuffie, Tamara Berg, and Molly B. Subarsky. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest So You Think You Can Dance news and gossip. If you'd like to buzz in on tonight's show, you can buzz us at 424-256-1729. That's 424-256-1729. And now, picking up where the show leaves off, and the buzz continues, Kat Bayless!
Y'all, and welcome to AfterBuzz TV So You Think You Can Dance with Molly B and Kat B. Did you realize, Molly, that you and I both have the B situation going on?
I didn't until now, and I love it.
I know, that's our nickname.
I love it, it sounds so great.
It's really Molly B. Savarsky.
Yes.
And Kat Bayless. But anyway, we would say hello, Ashanti. Hello, Tamara. Where are y'all?
We love you and miss you.
I know. But anyway, we are here tonight, y'all. It's season 8, episode 10, the top 16 perform. Da 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 da.
I love when there's less people left.
I know.
We're getting down.
Here's the thing. They still need to be even further down the line because they didn't eliminate those four people like 2 weeks ago, right?
Right. No, of course.
Well, anyway, we do have our faves, and I love the fact that Molly and I are totally on the same page.
Totally.
Because otherwise there'd be some cat fighting up in here.
We just had a party for 2 hours.
Phil's fixing the cameras for us so we make us a little prettier. Little partier.
By the way, add a darker shade tone to make us look tanner.
Oh,
you can do that.
Well, we're wearing the brighter colors, Molly.
We just are, so we look, and we planned like, that.
Yeah,
that
I know.
Was great.
I know.
It was fabulous.
Like totally for sure.
So this is a girly time.
This is the first time that we've actually ever been on air together, yes. And actually met was
and
earlier,
met, and it was love at first sight.
It was. Oh my god. Was, I know.
We just like totally had a party for 2 hours.
We did. We did. Which, by the way, I kind of felt like it flew by tonight.
Me too.
In earlier episodes, it was kind of hard to get through the show because there was just so much. But tonight, we got to see so much drama and so much personality out of the dancers.
Yes. It's time. It's time to give it your all.
It is.
I think this season is really like getting intense now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, people are trying harder to win.
Well, and also we're getting into the genres where people don't feel as comfortable.
Right, out of their comfort zone.
Right, exactly. But before we start, I want to remind everybody out there that Maria's book is still a number one bestseller, The Evergirl's Guide to Life.
It is so hard to get now. They're running out of books.
It's true.
So go and get a copy
immediately. It's true. Molly, I have to say this. I mean, I said this on an earlier episode, but my mom was talking with one of her best friends, and she's like, oh my God, I just bought this brand new book. And Maria Menounos's book. My mother goes, are you kidding me right now? Because my mom knows that I work with Maria and everything. She's like, and she didn't say, she's like, well, Kat, it's all over. Like, you know, women are like dying over it, and you know it's your guide to everything, working out and
anything you really could ever want to know is in the book.
But Maria's
so
just
well
an amazing person
too.
In general. We love you, Maria. We miss you.
Yes, we do. We love you. Come
you
back.
You need to come be on
you
So You Think You Can Dance with us.
Yes.
The
or just come here
girls.
And just dance with us here.
Which we will be dancing later.
Yes,
Molly
will.
Has a performance for all of
Stay
you.
Stay tuned.
She's going to shoot me in a minute. So let's just jump right in. Who's our favorite person right now who's on screen?
Wait.
Kristen Chenoweth.
Obsessed. Obsessed. I literally, the whole night, were we just like talking to her on the screen?
First of all.
Everything about her.
Like, honestly, I wrote something down about her because it's like.
All her quotes.
She has more quotes than God. And like.
Literally.
And it's hilarious. The fact that she's probably the tiniest person I've ever seen in my entire life. She's probably like 4'11". I'm not kidding.
And I love her. I mean, there's nothing wrong with her.
This is my quote for her. Big things come in small packages.
Of course.
Because she's so big.
She is.
Like, she should have her own talk show after this.
Oh,
I'm not kidding you.
Completely. 1,000%. Yeah. I mean, she, everything about her, everything she says, like, even, and she tries to, like, she said tonight, I don't want to be the Paula Abdul of So You Think You Can Dance. And I love that because we were saying, you know, like, she reminds us, you know, because she's so nice. But she has a way of just making everyone feel good.
It's true.
But even she's, just looking at her.
I know. And like Kristen Chenoweth, for all of you out there who don't know who she is, she's probably one of the biggest Broadway stars ever.
Does it all.
Everything. Sing, dances, acts. And, she, you know, you've probably seen her, you know, recently in a bunch of movies. I mean, this was a cheesy movie, but I loved it. It's called Four Christmases. And she was so good in that.
Great movie.
Yeah, exactly. Fabulous. And, but no, I felt like, I really love what they're doing this season, bringing in these Broadway stars. They brought in Megan Mullally a couple weeks ago, which, right. you know, from Will and Grace. I honestly had no idea that she was that big of a Broadway dancer star. You know, all I know is her is from Karen on Will and Grace.
Right.
Right?
No, of course.
But anyway, let's jump right in. So we started off with, the Ray Charles number, Hit the Road Jack, with half the cast.
Oh, love that.
Yeah.
Love that.
And then the chairs had the lights underneath them.
They were wearing black and white, right?
Yeah.
I love, especially in dancers coming from dancers themselves, I love black and white outfits.
Yeah.
Everyone just looks coordinated. The dance looks more together, I find.
You know what it reminds me of? Is Fosse.
Yes.
Like, very Fosse-esque. Here it is, right here.
Oh.
You know, there you go. We're watching on screen right now, you know.
The leather and the
yeah.
The, were they wearing sunglasses?
Oh, they're in sunglasses.
And the chair. I love chair dancing,
this is,
too.
Yeah. I mean, this is definitely, see, there's the white trim on the shoes and everything, and then they got the lights.
It.
Yeah.
This
it was fantastic.
Great. I happen to have liked this group dance better than the ending one.
Me too. And I don't know what you think about this, Molly, but last week I was talking about how Ryan is so front and center on all the dances. Like, I think
always.
They make sure, you know, I thought she was going to be kicked off, but they kept her.
Right.
You know what I mean?
No,
and I feel
course.
Like she's a favorite with the judges and with the producers of So You Think You Can
Dance.
I mean,
the stars will shine, you know? They come through in the group, I think,
yeah,
so.
Me too. So we first start off with Sasha and Alexander.
Right, okay. They had the...
What'd you think? It was the contemporary dance.
Contemporary dance.
We love this music, though. It was the piano.
I love the piano. Mm-hmm. I think the word is irked at the end.
Yes.
With the hands coming.
I
felt a little horror movie-ish. Like, and I looked at you, and you looked at me, and you're like, that's just a little off.
Well, it was. I mean, it was a beautiful piece, and the song was gorgeous, called Belong by Carey Brothers.
And I loved how he played the piano, too. That was nice.
Yeah, it was. But then it's just... You know, sometimes the choices these choreographers make, it doesn't fit with the dancers, in my opinion.
Right.
And we'll get to, like, one of those examples in a minute.
Can't
but,
wait.
Yeah, exactly. I'll just go ahead and say Beetlejuice, really.
I don't even know if I can, like, hold it in, but we can wait till we get there.
We can wait. But I think that I did like what they said about Sasha. Sasha's the one that has a sister that didn't actually make it into the top 20.
Right.
But Sasha's got a cool little story. Like, you know, she started off, she's a tomboy. And to think that this little frog.
Oh, yeah, she played the frog. With the unitard.
Yeah,
and the
unitard. And, like, so Nigel Lithgow pretty much said, look, you know, it's beautiful to see this frog turn into a beautiful princess, which she did. And she, you wouldn't even guess that she was a tomboy from the way that she danced tonight.
Right. No, she was awesome.
Nothing against tomboys.
And you said she had the sister, right? That also tried out, but she didn't.
The sister, they went along for the ride the whole time until the very, very end. And then,
and then
the sister got cut.
Cut, okay.
Which, you know...
That's got to be hard.
It is, but the sister has a different body type.
Right.
She has a different look.
Right.
And Sasha has more of the So You Think You Can Dance type.
Okay.
Her sister was a little bit, you know, on the bigger side.
Right.
Bigger bone and, like, more of a... But I felt sometimes like the sister... was more internal as a dancer. And I don't
and
know.
That and with this type of show, like we were saying before, stage presence is everything.
It is.
You know, if you're the best technical dancer on earth and you got a blank face, no one's gonna look at you.
Well, also I think, you know, it's kind of this show is kind of there's no, you know, chubby people on the show.
No, never.
Everyone's fierce.
We were saying that. Everyone has a sick body.
Yes,
everyone.
But the sister didn't.
Right. And that,
so,
do you think that
Yeah,
hurt
of course
her?
I did. Uh-huh.
Right.
I did. really do. And that's just me, because I know that she was a beautiful dancer. But then again, sometimes it is hard for a male. These guys are tiny.
Right.
There's not one guy that looks like a man.
They're all like,
yes,
just like,
yeah, and,
down.
And if they look this tiny on TV, I mean, they've got to be, like, yeah, super tiny. So,
and yeah,
you know, I mean, look at Jess. Jess is, like, maybe, what, 4'11"? Yes. I mean, okay. You're adorable. If you're 5'3", I'm sorry.
Love you.
Yeah.
We mean that in the nicest way possible.
We're going to get hate mail.
Shit. And I just said shit. Okay.
Like I said, big things come in small packages.
You did. You did say that.
Mm-hmm.
So what would... Oh, and also, I think it was... I don't know which judge said this, but they said that Sasha was like a beautiful princess.
Yeah.
And completely amazing at everything she did.
Yeah. A couple of them did.
And I agree with that.
Wait, we have to do our Mary Murphy. Oh, we're going to wait for our Mary Murphy moment. Yeah. We're going to wait till our favorite dance is the Mary Murphy.
You do it great. Okay. That's you. That's all you. That comes to you. That's all your part right there.
Oh, I love it. But I thought the acting was... Oh, I loved what Mary Murphy said about... this was Kristen Chenoweth about the extensions. She's like, oh my God, you know... Your extensions are longer than the ones that are on my head. Obviously, Kristen Chenoweth has extensions because, right. You know, most celebrities do.
But she rocks them.
She did. I couldn't tell. She should have told.
I never would have. I mean, her hair was up.
Yeah.
And I was complimenting her.
Yeah,
I love
that's what you wear at night when you go out at night. When you go clubbing.
Yeah.
I
haven't done that in a while. Mm-hmm. Anyway.
You've been working too much here, girlfriend. AfterBuzz TV.
Woo,
that's right.
AfterBuzz. Get it.
Yeah. Let's move on to number two, Caitlyn and Mitchell.
Okay, so Caitlyn and Mitchell, this was Put It in a Love Song, right? Was that?
Yep, Put It in a Love Song by Alicia Keys. And,
great song.
Jean-Marc choreographed it. Mm-hmm.
I think that was a great song. I thought that Jordan was amazing. Wait, what was this?
This
not
Caitlyn
Jordan.
And Mitchell.
Caitlyn and Mitchell. I'm looking at Jordan on my page here.
I know.
Mitchell.
And Mitch, I don't know.
What did you think?
Remember, I was
there was a certain discomfort at some point.
I didn't feel like there was any chemistry between the two of them.
Right. Okay. Right. We were saying, and I was saying to you, how do people get partnered up? Because some people work amazing together, and then you get something like this where you're a little bit.
My personal opinion on this is definitely the height thing and the weight thing, because this person is going to be lifting you the whole time.
Right.
And another thing, too, you need to think about the genre factor, because if you've got, let's say, I'm like this prima ballerina over here and you're like some badass hip-hop dancer.
Hip-hop, get down.
You know, the two of us together are going to be Barbie on crack.
Right,
no.
No.
It doesn't work. So that's kind of what I feel like. That's how they match people up.
Right.
You got to remember, too, we're down to the top 20, 16 dancers now.
Right.
Not 20 anymore, 16. But, these people are all amazing.
Yeah.
They can do every style of dance because they made it this far. We got to remember that.
Well, and that's why I think that it's, Kristen doesn't really have anything bad to say, because the reality is that everyone is good. At this point, everybody is good.
Yeah.
So what do you think separates a winner from someone who isn't, going to make it that far? As a dancer yourself.
For me, they're all amazing dancers, technically.
Right.
It's the stage presence and the inner beauty that comes out on that stage.
I agree.
Which I will jump to Melanie. Not yet.
Just going to say that.
I don't want to give it away. We're going to get to her. But
okay.
She, by far, has the best stage presence.
It's almost ridiculous.
I felt like I was in her movie. And
I had chills.
And yeah, me
when
too.
I was watching her.
Ridiculous. We were grabbing each other.
We were literally like, oh my God, what's going on? We were so excited.
Little girls. Oh, I will say this about Mitchell. We'll go back to Mitchell on this dance. They called him the Chris Rock of So You Think You Can Dance.
Yes, they did, and I have that written down here.
He's brought style to the program, and, I do agree, but Mitchell isn't the best dancer to me. He's amazing and all, but, I feel like I'm a personality
type
of person.
That there's
better? Mm-hmm.
Okay.
He doesn't, he's amazing, but he just doesn't say, I'm going to win.
Right. And that's kind of,
I'm already jumping to predictions right now, but yeah. I mean, who knows? I mean, he could, you know, make it to the very end. I mean, we never know. Like, I thought that Ryan was going to be kicked off last week, and she wasn't.
And you never know. Yeah, it's all, it's like week by, you know, you never really know.
No.
You know? And also, I just wanted to say another thing about how we were talking about the songs and the type of dance. We were kind of talking about how on American Idol, you know, when people get, you know, genres that they're not necessarily comfortable with.
Yeah.
You know, and then they kind of get dissed for it. Yeah. And I think that, you know, here, Nigel brought up a good point, you know, when we, I don't know if I can jump to this right now.
Yeah, go ahead.
But for that number, who was it by, Telepath or something? What was that?
Oh, God, by Sonya.
Oh.
Telepath, you're right.
Okay.
Yes.
That was, like, it was awkward.
I mean.
And I liked how you made that comparison with American Idol, because it's like, you know, people are good at what, you know, what they're good at. Like, right. You know, everyone's good at different things.
Well,
but
also, American Idol, and we will compare to American Idol, because American Idol,
it's
the
similar.
The kids got to pick the songs that each week.
Right.
Well, the dancers don't get to pick the song. The choreographer picks the song.
Exactly.
And I don't think that Sonya did a good job picking this song for this Beetlejuice number.
And the people
and
that
we'll just jump right to that one. And we'll go back to, yeah,
okay.
Let's go ahead and jump to that, because honestly, it's like, really?
Lights Go Down by Telepath?
Yeah.
Right, okay.
Yeah, yeah. And I mean, I wrote down here before he even said it, the music sucked. And it just, I didn't understand the story, and they had half a face was Beetlejuice, half the face was normal.
Right.
And
that was weird.
Which stunk, because Ashley has the prettiest legs in the entire competition.
What was the line that... Okay, everybody. Can we get a round? Can we get like an applause on here? We need like an applause sound. No, because that deserves an applause. And I'm going to give it. I'll give it.
One of these days, I'm going to wear like.
Kat, everyone.
Thank you.
She's amazing. Everyone needs to realize it. Okay.
One of these days, I'm going to actually like wear like dance gear.
I was just going
to
say.
And like show off my extension just to compare it to Ashley.
And we know how talented Kat is, because she didn't even warm up just now. If that hurts tomorrow, I'm sorry, but you just killed that.
Girl,
so,
thank you. Stop,
everyone, okay,
stop
that was
it.
Great. That was great, and it needed to happen, and that was awesome. That's just a sneak peek, everyone. She'll be performing later.
I'm kidding.
Anyway, right, so her extensions were ridiculous.
Yeah, it's crazy. But
what else we had on here? Nigel said that.
He did connect.
And then he said something like, if you're going to do a dance like this, you have to be over the top. That's what he said.
Correct.
So where do you think, they just weren't as into it as Nigel would have hoped? Like, they needed to be, what, more crazy, more, you know?
I feel as though even when they were showing them in rehearsal, and he's like, he was really nervous because I'm talking about Chris. Chris is like, oh, God, I have Sonya tonight or whatever.
Right.
And then he goes, you know what? I'm not gonna get all nervous, but you know that she's choreographing or whatever. I'm just gonna get into the piece, and I'm gonna get crazy, and I'm gonna think like I'm a zombie. Well, they didn't do it,
right?
You know, I mean, they did as much as they could with the material.
I think they were as weird as
the dancing
they
was
been.
Phenomenal. I'm not gonna say the dancing was amazing.
They're great.
Did the choreography.
They're great dancers.
Yeah,
yes.
But the music. It was a sleeper.
And it hurt them. I think it hurt them in the end, because
it did. It wasn't fair.
They're so great that they could have, you know, kind of exceeded in another, you know, type of dance or song.
I loved what Kristen Chenoweth said on this. She's like, well, this should just be called So You Think You Can Partner.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Like, I mean, that was a great line, but I thought to myself, like, do you think you can partner? Like, pick a partner.
Right.
That's good for you? Like, I was like, I loved it. Like, I loved the saying, but I, like, didn't quite get it.
Well, okay, I'll explain. Because, so you think you can dance? Yeah, okay, that's what this competition is about.
Right.
Can you dance? But, I'm sorry.
Can you dance with
a partner? Because it's different. You and I are both dancers. Did we grow up partnering?
No.
No, but do we partner when we did ballets? Yes.
Yes.
Was it hard? Yes.
Yes.
Some of these dancers have never partnered. These bebop breakdancer guys.
It's hard.
They have no idea how to lift a girl in the right place. These, even just lifting a girl, like the Dirty Dancing lift, you know, in the water, is hard.
Oh, my God. Great movie.
Exactly.
No, I totally agree. And, you know, dancing, that's what I kind of find interesting about the show, because it's towards the end that they're dancing alone, that they stop partnering, correct?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And it's like, it's just a whole, dancing with someone else as opposed to dancing by yourself, you're competing against them, but you're also their partner. And I feel like it creates like,
well,
it's like you love them because you've been spending all this time with them, but you're really against them, but you're together.
You are. But it's going to hurt you in the long run if you don't connect with your partner, because people aren't going to like your routine.
So you need to be friendly until the point where you're alone.
You need to be in it, like Melanie and Marco. We'll get to that in a second.
They're so amazing. I want to get there.
Okay. Well, anyway, you know, I did understand why they said, Ashley, you're like the sleeper cell in the competition, because this is what C said. Because, you know, Ashley, honestly, is that girl every time I watch it. I'm like, oh, yeah, she is good. That girl's good.
Yeah.
You know?
And then, no, she's awesome.
I mean, and she did have that amazing number last week with the jail and the bars.
Oh, I love that. I love that.
Like, the leg through, and it was fantastic.
You're great.
Stop it. Okay. We're dancing over here. We can't help it.
I hope Phil plays music at the end.
Oh, yeah. That'd be great. Phil, will you play some music for us at the end so we can dance? Because we're hyper up in here.
We're like hyped.
Hey.
Oh, and Kat sings too, obviously.
Not yet. We're not dancing yet. We have to get through this.
And this is Phil. That's not hype enough, but thanks, Phil.
Oh, no, she didn't. She's napsing around the world. Okay. And now we're on to my personal friend, Robert Taylor Jr.
Obsessed with him. Mm-hmm. Obsessed with him.
Well, Ashanti would say that, you know, he was like the Steve Urkel of the show, whatever. But he's got so much personality.
Great smile.
Great
smile. I just loved hearing him talk in that, like, little intro when they talk about their life. Mm-hmm. And that's awesome because you worked with him.
It was. I mean, we did Joseph and the amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. And he was
amazing.
The same guy. Like, honestly, he was just that
hyper. You said he hasn't changed in 10 years.
No! He hasn't changed at all. Like, he's just, he's got this bright light that shines, and that's what's shining through, you know, through the cameras. Again, like, you know, is he the best dancer, probably, of all the guys that they picked to be in the top, you know, 16? No. Probably not. But he's got that personality. You know? But he and Miranda, I thought, did a great job. I thought he outshined her, but
he was definitely better.
They did the Tyce D'Oria number. It don't mean a thing if you ain't got that swing. And they had some fast little, like, cha-cha-chas going on up in there.
That was great.
Yeah, it was great. And, you know, just like I said, like, Kristen Chenoweth said, you killed it, you know. And
I love saying you killed it. That's, like, my favorite line.
Yeah, you killed it. And her other line, too, is, like, shut the front door. The back door.
The side door.
The garage door.
That's great. I
connect with Kristen on this one because I'm always like, oh my God, shut the front door or shut up. Like, I'm
you
always.
You two are very alike.
You think so?
I know so. I saw, she, first of all, you would say something and then she would say it right after.
It was so
and I was
weird.
Like, weirded out. I'm like, did you guys like talk before this? Like, that was weird. Like, you know, every time. It happened more than once, but it was great.
I will say, like, every role that she's ever done, like on Broadway, like, she did Glinda. In Wicked.
Okay.
Did you ever see Wicked on Broadway? She originated Glinda, you know, the Good Witch. And so everyone's like, Kat, that is like your role. And I'm like, yeah, if I was like a freaking bird soprano, my voice is like a man over here.
I mean, Phil's chuckling.
Is he?
He is. I can see him too.
I can't see Phil's mouth or anything. So I don't know if he's rolling his eyes at me or not.
That's Phil.
I'll take it. Cha-ching.
Wait. But, I'm so excited because we're getting close to our favorite. Yeah.
Oh,
are they next?
She also said, you know, legs like that, who needs arms? Miranda. Because
she did.
Woo! Woo, girl.
Was killing it.
Yeah, that red dress. Woo!
And that red lipstick and that little curl. And she was sexy,
hot.
She was hot.
Much hotter than I thought she was gonna be because actually said that in rehearsal
she's like a classy, sexy.
Yeah,
yeah. Mm-hmm. And when we were watching her, I was not expecting a red dress, red lipstick, and a whole lot of attitude from her. Mm-mm. And I thought she was totally out there.
I felt like great. I was watching a piece on Broadway.
She was. That was a great number.
And Tice is a great, great choreographer. So props to him too.
That was great.
Okay, here we go. Mary Murphy. The trains are rolling. Melanie and Marco. I mean, whatever. I'm like done with the show now.
I know. Same. Let's just talk about them for the rest of...
What was that feel? Okay.
No idea. Is that like a boo?
Is that
like
a boo for me?
Is that like a weird... Okay, that...
No.
Okay, that... Okay, so we're not done with the show? Is that because we said that? I don't know what just happened.
Okay, we got it. I'm going to come have a word with you in the booth, Phil.
Okay. But take it away, Kat. So we're at...
By far the best number, I thought, of the night.
Honestly, I may have, like, almost cried.
Yeah, I think, yeah.
We both had chills.
Well,
we were...
I didn't think it could get any better. And then, the kiss?
First of all, that... I had no idea that was coming.
Mm-mm.
But what about, then, the kisses with everybody else?
Every single judge. Okay, first to start with Nigel kissing Mary.
Oh, right.
And then Kristen.
She was all blushed.
And then Nigel kissing C.
And then what about, oh my God. I'm like so excited. I'm forgetting names.
Wait, Kat Dealey.
No. Oh, yes. It was her and Marco.
Yeah.
Marco tried to kiss her and she was just like, no.
They were pretty much saying, no tongue people tonight.
Yeah, that was insane. That was like, I hope that was all improv because that was amazing.
They're the power couple to beat.
They are.
Hands down.
And that was what they said. They are the couple to beat. And she, like you said, looks so much like Jennifer Goodwin.
It's kind of weird.
It's
scary.
The same face.
It's a little scary. Yeah, same face.
And same
haircut. I don't even care if Jennifer...
Should you just finish all my sentences?
Yeah.
Because, I don't know what happened. We don't even have a script, and we're no.
This is how we roll. We just met literally 2 hours ago, y'all.
Literally.
Molly and I. Okay, so get ready for this.
Get ready. We're the new team to beat.
Thanks, Phil, for putting us together.
Yeah. We declare a meeting with you, by the way, later.
But Tabitha and Napoleon...
Great.
...ruled the night with their choreography. It was... I mean, here's the other thing I wanted to reiterate was that they are a couple, you know, and for them to choreograph these love stories or these makeout stories or these morning after stories, as we'll get to towards the end with Jordan
that was great.
And Tad. But I feel as though sometimes I'm watching them dance as well.
Right.
And I love them. I love their choreography.
The best is when they cut to them after a number and they're kissing or they're hugging. And it's just, I love that. I love that about them. And I love how they kind of put their relationship into the numbers that they choreograph. You can kind of see their relationship in the dances that they teach to other people.
Well, you know, just with anything, as a songwriter, I feel as though you write about what's going on in your life at that moment in time. And maybe this is kind of what they're going through at that moment in time.
And I love that.
Yeah.
They're great. Their dances always seem to be the one that we, you know, love the most.
Of course. I call it my romantic comedy numbers. Mm-hmm. What's going on?
I don't know. I just don't.
I'm trying to yell at Molly for always crinkling the...
Sorry.
Oh, am I?
Let me just check my. Yep. Everyone knows I'm checking my notes.
Oh.
I'm not really checking them. I'm just. You really can't even read them.
Don't be a hater, alligator.
Okay. Sorry.
Don't even worry about it. Listen, I do this all the time because I'm always wearing little
bangles. Kat's got my back. Thank you.
I got your back, girl.
Thank you.
But that one, I had notes galore as well. I can't say enough about that number. I can't watch that number enough. I'm probably going to go watch it 5 times.
We were going to rewind it.
and then we
realized we were time sensitive.
Yes.
So, you know, now we're here and
it's
talking
okay.
about it. But we'll probably watch it later. So that's
of course.
Fine.
That's that how we roll.
That mm-hmm. is how we roll. So, is that all we have to say about them?
Yeah, because we got to move on.
We need to move on. Okay.
But, so next. Next, we've got Ashley and Chris, and they did the jazz number with Sonya.
Okay.
And this was Actually, I take that back. We just talked about them. They were number five. We jumped to them already.
Oh, we did?
Yeah, the telepath thing.
Okay, I got it.
Done.
And it was weird because we were saying that it was really difficult to switch modes from our, like, oh my God, like, romantic love story to, like, different faces and, yeah, like, weird stuff that was going on. We were kind of over it.
Right? I hope they don't go home because of, like, a bad song choice. I really don't, because I don't think they deserve it.
I don't either.
But that was my least favorite dance of the night.
Me too. I completely agree.
Least. Oh, and then, okay. Jess, could you be any cuter? Jess and Clarice
No.
did the foxtrot, and it was like a Rat Pack number, Fred Astaire, Ginger. And, I mean, it was perfection. I felt like I just wanted to get up and dance with you.
Yeah.
Like,
did we? I feel like we did at one point.
We didn't get to. Because we didn't get to.
But we were, again, time sensitive. And we were ready to party.
It was phenomenal.
That was
like,
cute.
Jess is going to be a huge Broadway star. I really feel it. Yeah. I hope he can sing, because the boy can dance his butt off.
He's so little
and darling and but they did give him like a huge, huge compliment. They were like, you know, you're like the only guy, the only person on this show that could actually do that dance. And they did say something. Remember they said something about you might not have the best technique of the foxtrot, but yet your presence and your personality and your performance would outshine anybody.
Yeah. And that's kind of been like our theme of the night, I feel like.
Yeah.
I feel like, you know, we've been, you know, saying it's all about personality. And you even said, and I promise I won't bring her up again because we can't keep going back, when Melanie first came on, you were literally yelling at the TV saying, like, she is working that camera.
Yeah.
And you could not have been more right, because she was completely, you were falling in love with her.
Okay. But
like her eyes even was like, you just wanted to like love her.
Well, and the piece, we will go back for a second, because the piece was a man who was left at the altar, which is Marco, who was crying. Literally crying.
He literally was crying in the beginning.
Yeah,
he said to me, is he crying? I'm like, yeah.
Yeah. He was crying.
Yeah.
I mean, that acting piece, honey, A+. And then when she came up, you felt that warmth of her just like, I'm going to love you. And like that smile, it wasn't fake.
It was great.
It was
That was not even acting.
If you
acting.
Didn't see it, go watch it.
Seriously, like, go watch the show tonight to, like, see that part.
Just see Melanie and Marco's number.
Personally, it, like, made my night. I was in a great mood
I wasn't feeling the show until that number.
Agreed. Agreed. From one B to another.
All right. So I will say that Ryan and his part in her partner, which I forgot because I didn't even pay attention on this number. Did you? No.
No.
We were so bad.
We were bad.
It was a very weird number with a ribbon, and he was pulling it.
And we like kind of said like, should we rewind it? And then we didn't.
It's really awful. There was like no makeup. It was bad costumes, and I felt like,
I didn't like
Ryan
that.
Was the one they picked last week to stay. And I don't know. I have mixed feelings about her because her solo performance last week.
No.
I mean,
I see them kind of not going much further.
I don't know.
That's either. Like, that could be an iffy subject.
Well, prediction on that one, yes, that one will be.
Prediction. Save it for the end.
Yeah, I am. And number eight, our last couple, were Tad and Jordan.
Okay.
Another Tabitha and Napoleon. What is going on? What are they drinking? What water are they drinking?
Can they just choreograph everyone's dances so that the show...
Wait, it started off like this. Under the
covers. Under the covers, in the bed. And they come off.
I'm like, are they naked?
Oh my God, like we just had some
Or we did fun? What? We don't know.
We don't know.
Great,
like, amazing song, too. Great song.
What was the name of that song?
All the things we did last night. Memories. I forget who it was, but great song. Good club song.
David Guetta. Did I say it right?
That was great.
Was that good?
That was good.
Thank you. I've been working on my Spanish.
Killing it.
Just killed it. Yeah. It's just, they're A-list choreographers, and it was just it was the piece was
endless. They're so talented. They really are.
You know, and I feel like some of the other dancers, you know, were at a disadvantage because of this.
They're kind of getting, like, screwed. Yeah. Like, I feel like the people that get them are like, okay.
Yeah.
We know the dance that we're going to get. We are going to do nothing less than amazing at. You know? And
yeah.
And I couldn't have said it better. They're at a disadvantage.
So wait, let's say it again. Let's say it again. What did Kristen Chenoweth say? Again, here we go. Simultaneously, shut the front door.
The back door.
There's the side door. The garage door. The cat door. No pun intended.
That was great. No pun intended. That is great. But she's a ball of energy.
I love her.
I think she makes the show, too.
Well, I hope she's on it again. And yeah. I mean, she's probably going to be on it tomorrow night. I hope she's on it continuously because...
I think she's a great asset to the show.
Yeah. I mean, but they've had some pretty good people on there as well.
Oh,
but
yeah.
Still.
For sure.
So then
we came to the last group dance. Now, what did you...
Medieval times. They were like the women were poisoning the men with the goblets and the wine. It reminded me of Romeo and Juliet.
Oh, right. Romeo and Juliet.
The lines were pretty. I liked the dancing. I just felt like the first number, they had an advantage over the last number. But they're not really getting judged on those numbers. I feel like they are trying to show the versatility.
Right. But I thought that I thought the first group dance was better, overall.
Yeah, but like I think I said that's, that. But... You know, I just like that style better, too.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, totally. Get it.
So anything else you want to add to that?
That was the show
overall. That was the show. I think that now, once we eliminate, you know, a couple more dancers, the show's going to just flow a little better.
I'm kind of ready for it to get, like, more intense.
I'm ready for it to be a competition.
I want to, like, fall in love with people and, like, be so obsessed with them that, like, they must win.
Yeah. Well, yeah, but there's just too many people right now.
There's too many people.
It's really hard. I mean, even, like, Ashanti and Tammy last week were like... We're getting mixed up on the names because it's not like American Idol where they show you, they tell you about the hometown and like you know everything and
everything about everyone.
They try to do it here, but there's just too many people.
No.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And but I do have to say that these are probably some of my most favorite dancers in the past, like, you know.
Oh, for sure.
Eight seasons or whatever it was.
I completely agree with you about that.
So are we going to go to commercial break, Phil?
Is it time?
Want to find out what the AfterBuzz is about?
Janice is a drama queen.
This is the divide that is going to carry the series.
Give us a call. 424-256-1729. 424-256-1729.
Big television, and they want it to be as dramatic as possible.
I mean, it's Shakespearean.
You never know what goes on behind closed doors.
Find out why AfterBuzz TV is the number one source for after-show content.
Now, in the eyes of Jimmy... Nucky is a villain.
424-256-1729.
424-256-1729.
I mean, who would you guys rather hear that from? Your husband or your best friend?
The wig!
The wig will come out.
When the TV show is over, get your AfterBuzz on.
AfterBuzz.
Okay.
Phil for that fantastic
song.
Oh, of course, this is Phil's favorite song in the whole world.
Yes, I've heard of it. Thanks, Phil. Thanks for the shout out.
Thanks to Phil's VTech for the wonderful DJ Janity's job.
DJ Phil, everybody.
Yeah. Well, we are back and it's time for predictions. And I think that we are going to start with Molly.
And now,
okay.
You're after Buzz TV predictions.
It gets creepier every time.
I need to make a predictions dance next week.
Yeah, we're going to have routines next week, everybody. Like, we're working on that. So.
Okay.
You probably, like, know what I'm going to say.
Yeah, I do.
Okay. So, favorite girl.
Because I can read your mind.
You like, can, and it's, like, weird, because, like, it's weird, but that's okay. Just act surprised, because, like, this is our predictions time.
Wait, act surprised. Here we go.
So, favorite girl, Melanie.
No way!
Like, did you know I was gonna say that? You didn't know, right?
No.
You had no idea.
No idea whatsoever.
Okay.
No.
Melanie is my favorite. Let's see. I love Marco, but I also love Jordan, I think. Yeah. I love Jordan.
Pick a guy and a girl.
Okay.
Favorite girl is Melanie, right?
Favorite girl is Melanie. I like Mitchell.
Mm-hmm.
I like Mitchell.
Yeah.
A lot.
Yeah.
I don't feel about a boy how I feel about Melanie. Yeah. Like, I'm just not physically there yet. Or, like, emotionally there yet.
All right. That's fair. You know, I feel
Robert. Maybe I would say. I would pick them, too.
Okay. Who do you think is going home tomorrow night?
Tomorrow night? That's big.
Guy and a girl. Your first choice.
You know what? That's a tough decision. Who do you think is going
Ron.
Home? You think he's
Ryan,
going
Ryan, your girl.
Okay. Oh!
I think the paper's going home.
All right. You know what?
Be nice,
All right,
Theo.
You know what? I'm sorry. I don't know what else to do.
Don't even. Listen to him.
I'm throwing you over the side.
Who can make the best paper sound?
Okay, I'm sorry, everyone. I'm apologizing. I didn't realize that my paper was crumbling.
It's not
anyway.
That big of a deal. We still love you.
Thank you,
Molly's
Kat.
New and brightening up the studio. I love her.
You're too sweet. Thank you.
No, I'm just telling the truth.
I'm learning from the best, obviously.
Oh, good.
And it's not Phil. Just kidding. JK.
Roommates, beware. Well, my favorite is Melanie.
Okay.
And I really, even though I didn't like the number, I think Ashley is a fantastic dancer.
I agree.
I love her energy and her presence, but Melanie by far is my favorite. Guy-wise, I'm a little biased. I love Robert.
I think he's my favorite.
There he is dancing right now for us. But if we want to get really technical, you know, Marco is phenomenal.
Like, ridiculous.
Yeah, and he's got that inner something, that acting part side of it, too, that not a lot of the guys have.
Right.
They just have the technical side. So,
right.
And I think, again, I think Ryan's going home, and I think her partner.
I think tomorrow's going to be really interesting.
It's going to be a shocker.
Obviously, there are people that are obviously making it through. But I think that there's, like, a bunch of people that could be, like, on the lower end. And, like, we're just not.
But America's voting.
America's
voting. But then, you know, the.
Oh, she's so fabulous.
I know.
We're
looking at Kristen Chenoweth. Love. We're in love. We have a girl crush.
I have a girl crush.
Girl crush.
She's my girl crush.
Like, I had a girl crush with her on her, like, in all of her movies and on Broadway. But, like, this is her personality.
This is a bigger crush. How she really is.
She's, like, a huge superstar.
She's fabulous.
She's light.
I hope she sees this because we're, like, really big fans.
Yeah, we're, like, so big fans.
And we're, like, girl crushes.
All right, y'all. What is that, Phil?
Oh, my God. I don't, like, even
that
know
what that is. Not the AfterBuzz song.
This is. Okay.
Oh.
Okay, so
it's just the crush song. And now we saw
them.
We take the floor.
Work it!
That was for you, Phil. Because we have a Phil crush. All right, you got your dancing in, Phil.
Yeah.
You got to see the girls shake it.
From producers Kevin Undergaro and Phil Svitek, engineer DJ Jesse Janity, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. If you have questions or comments, be sure to buzz us at info@AfterBuzzTV.com. And you can find us on Facebook or follow us on Twitter by searching for AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later!
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principal. I won't leave your side for